The Boston Red Sox are currently 2 games behind the second seed of the wild card. Obviously, a lot has changed since last year. Because last year, at this point of the season, the big question for the Red Sox was, how many records are they going to break as a team? This year's question is, are they going to make the playoffs? That's what we're going to be talking about today. But before we get into the video, if you guys are enjoying what you're seeing, make sure to smash that like button. And if you're new, make sure to hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell. And yeah, let's get into it. Boston Red Sox struggles have absolutely nothing to do with their offense. Now, of course, Mookie Betts and JD Martinez aren't putting up numbers like they did last year, but last year they were just unconscious. They were out of this world. They're still having great seasons. JD Martinez in 371 at-bats has a .294 average with 20 home runs, 55 RBIs. Mookie Betts in 399 at-bats has a .281 average with 15 home runs and 47 RBIs. And they had a lot more home runs and a lot more RBIs last year at this point, but this is still production. And of course, you're having Xander Bogaerts, who's having a career year. Rafael Devers, he's breaking out. Chavis, he's having an excellent year. Vasquez, so you cannot blame the offense, but you can 100% blame the pitching, both starters and the bullpen. The Red Sox have blown 17 saves as a team. They don't even really have a closer. I mean, they had Kimbrel last year. He's not there anymore, and they're obviously missing him right now. And the starting pitching for the Boston Red Sox, you look at Chris Sale. Yes, I know he's injured right now, and he has had a few good starts, but in general, this is not the Chris Sale that we all know. In 21 starts, he's 5-9, 4 ERA exactly, so he's really done a good job of lowering that. And he's got 182 strikeouts. He really struggled for most of the first half, which is why he's got the numbers that he's got now. He's really their only good starting pitcher. David Price has been so-so. Eduardo Rodriguez has been decent. And Rick Porcello? Yeah, let's not even go there. So what do the Red Sox do? They go and they trade for Andrew Kashner. I personally think that that was a pretty good move. Yes, he did not have a very good first start with them. Gave up 3 home runs and lost the game. But I do think that in the long run, once Andrew Kashner settles in, maybe it'll take him a couple of starts. I think that he will help the Red Sox, but that's not their only issue. They need to buy in order to make the playoffs. I don't see why they wouldn't buy or stay put. They're obviously not going to sell. I think that they should go and get a couple of bullpen arms and 100% get another starter. Andrew Kashner's not going to fix the problem all by himself. Nathan Eovaldi was the pickup last year that really, really ended up helping them throughout the playoffs. He's injured right now, and once he comes back, he's going to be a bullpen pitcher. So if you're the Red Sox, you at least need to get one more starter. And I am saying at least, because that rotation and that bullpen, they've got issues. And yes, I know they're playing in a tough division with the Yankees and the Rays to some extent, but that's not an excuse. You need to get better. And then the big question becomes, how big of a player do you go after? If they were maybe 1 or 2 games behind first place, you would go for the big guy, maybe a bigger player, give up more prospects, and go for the division win and try to go deep in the playoffs. But right now, there's no chance that the Red Sox win the division. So what does that mean? They need to go after a wild card spot. And that's a 1-game event. You lose that, you're out of the playoffs. So if I'm the Red Sox, I wouldn't give up too much, and I wouldn't go after the biggest starter in the market, but I would go after someone decent. Those are my opinions. I want you guys to let me know what you think in the comments down below, whether or not the Boston Red Sox will make the playoffs, and really, what do you guys think about them as a team in general? Also, like I said, if you guys like what you saw, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe if you are new, and I'll see you all next time.